So if I come to Cameroon now, you give me
what I'm saying. You don't have some where they roast that
time. Bobolo, okay. Plantain and bobolo, okay.
Roasted fish.
I can't wait to eat it, bobolo.
Yeah, and fish.
Roasted fish.
So what have we given to you now that you love so much in Nigeria?
As
in
Nigeria. Soup.
Abana soup. Only abana soup. You have not eaten oba with the stockfish.
Don't give me now. I'm eating abana.
But you have eaten oba with the stockfish.
No.
So you have not tested oba.
Yes.
I'm not tested. Are you sure? Not abana oba. No buruko. More can that.
No more oba here.
Oh, but that's your test, Tole. You have tested it.
Where am I going to go? Oba, should write the name of the stranger.
I am not here.
Hi, guys. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel, Evermore GST. So, today we have important person in our channel. She's a Cameroonian, okay? And I want to ask her how she feels about Nigerians, you know? Let's dive over and ask her what she thinks about Nigeria. Anyway, this is about Mom G's TV, so don't mind the noise, okay? I have the we have some visitors in the house. So, in case today is your first time of coming across this pretty face, don't hesitate to subscribe, okay? This is my hair. Mm-hmm. It's fine, okay. That's how they see my hair. I guess it's so lovely. So comment under the comment section. So let's dive into the end.
Oh, do
we have cows and
brothers? The richest daki in
Panabon. Cows and dollars. So hi guys, have you seen this pretty lady, pretty looking face, okay? So anyway, so let's just hear from her. So what's your name and what, okay?
I'm called Dora Mas from Cameroon.
Pounds and
Palabon. Pounds and dollars.
Oh, that is her name here in Germany.
Popular known as Pounds and Dollars.
Okay, do you hear that guy? So anyway, she's a lovely woman. She just can't look at her face. So pretty, okay? No, she has been a very good friend. So I just want to ask her what she thinks about Nigerians, okay? Or how she feels about Nigerians if she has come in contact with every, as in any other Nigerian, okay? So let's begin, okay? So how are you? You're looking pretty.
Thanks.
Okay. So you have a lot of Nigerian friends or just one family? Listen.
I don't have a lot of Nigerian friends, I just have one family, the Rexing family.
Okay, the Rexing
that
family.
That is not, I cannot even call them, like, I cannot call them friends, I can call them family, they're like my family friends, you know. We have been like 6 years together, I love this family, the husband, the wife, the children. They are like, I have to go to Nigeria, I don't think the relationship has to end only in Germany. I have to travel to see where they are coming from.
Oh,
I don't think I'm going to end it here.
Okay.
Now I'm not half Cameroon, half Nigerian.
Oh,
I'm not my full Cameroonian. Okay. Half, half.
Okay.
Nice family. Beautiful family.
So, what do you tell Cameroonians that maybe they have not come in contact with Nigerians?
Yes, I want to tell most of us Cameroonians, we believe that, some of us believe that Nigerians, they are very like tribalistic, they are not friendly, but it's not true, because I can give a testimony, like the Griffin family I know, they are soft-spoken, free-will, they are friendly, they are everything.
Oh.
So all Nigerians are not the same. If somebody tell you Nigeria they are tribalistic, it's lie.
Okay.
But I can give a testimony to this family.
Alright, okay. So, thank you so much, okay. And what do you say about me?
Oh! It's my sweet sister. It's the sister from my bestie,
okay.
My best friend in Germany, Florence Dirksen.
Okay.
That is the junior sister of Florence.
Ooh.
Beautiful, soft-spoken,
okay.
Good heart,
thank
and everything.
You.
As you see her like this, always joy, joy, joy.
Ooh.
You will need to see your great-great-grandchildren.
Amen.
Say amen.
Bigger amen. Bigger, louder amen.
Lovely family.
Oh, thank you so much. Okay, thank you so guys. So yes, I've not been to Cameroon, but I think I have a lot of friends, Nigerians, born and brought up in Cameroon. You know, they have said a lot of good things about Cameroon as a country, and they have contact with a lot of Cameroonians. They said Cameroonians are also accommodating. And I believe that because I have come in contact with pounds and dollars, a woman with a good heart. Honestly, it's not because maybe she's a friend. I have other Cameroonians that have come in contact with. They are such lovely people, you know. So I wish I'm coming to Cameroon.
No wish, you are already in Cameroon.
Okay, you're already is there. You see, in fact, I'm in Cameroon.
Your spirit is already in Cameroon.
Okay, how do I
greet
Cameroon? Now it's your shadow
I'm seeing, not your spirit.
Thank you so much. Yeah. So how do I greet Cameroonians out there? So how do I say, hello, good morning, kind of in with
like my Muttersprache or what?
In your Muttersprache or that.
You want my Muttersprache? You want to learn my Muttersprache?
Yes, I want to just say,
hello. Afono.
Cameroonians.
To the metals people.
Okay.
Afono.
Afono, and what again?
Like what you want to say?
My greetings to you. Oh, how are you?
How are you? ASEAN.
ASEAN Cameroonians. Okay. So guys, no, honestly, I love this video. The weather is so good, okay? Anyway, this is pounds and dollars, okay? So my Cameroonian friends out there, so you people have a good representative here in Germany. Honestly, this woman is representing Cameroonians as in full time. It's not half, okay?
Born and bred in Cameroon, from Boya, Southwest Province.
Okay, did you hear that? So, all the Cameroonians, thumbs up for you guys, because evidence to what my friends have taught me about Cameroon, you know, I have a lot and a lot of them born and brought up in Cameroon before they came back to Nigeria. So, for those of you that have bias over Nigerians, you have had pounds and dollars, dollars. Okay, thumbs up for us, okay? So you don't have any regrets.
If your child wants to get married to a Nigerian, don't be afraid, because most Cameroonians, they like to say, oh, you cannot get married to Nigerian, It depends.
If a Cameroonian gets married
to Drixin family, guarantee you 100%. They are Nigerians with difference.
Okay, Cameroonians, can you hear that?
Yes.
Okay.
Because most Cameroonians, we have that mentality. So don't get married to Nigerian. Because if you get married to Nigerian, no matter what, you will still go back to Nigeria and get married. I don't think it's like that. It depends on the family.
Okay, thank you so much. So Cameroonians, it depends on Cameroonians and depends on individuals and family. Okay, because I believe many people always say things, they generalize things. Venture. When you venture and come in contact
with the Igbos, not even the Benin or the Igbos, they specify on the Igbos. The Igbos, they don't get married to any, to Ghana, to Cameroon, to...
So, my Igbo brothers, be careful.
Yes, only Igbos, they get married only to Igbos.
No, not only Igbo. Even in Igbo land, I'm an Igbo woman. So, most states avoid some states. For example, Anambra people, some Anambra people, don't be offended, but you have to be, honest and be open. Most Anambra men, when they want to get married to Imo State, I came from Imo State, and they will like tell you, my parents doesn't like Imo ladies or Imo girls, because they think that Imo girls are so wild, but it's not like that. So, at times, within Igbos, we have such problems. So, it's not that Igbos are doing it to other countries or that. Within us Igbos, some Igbo state they don't like going to, so it's like that, but it depends on families, notwithstanding, there are many Igbo, there are many Imo state, that got married to Anambra, so it depends on what the man wants.
Yeah.
It depends on how the man sees himself as a man.
But if the man say, if the family say, no, you must not marry this woman, what
it always gives problem, because when that man, happens to marry that lady in particular, the sister-in-laws, the mother-in-law, they becomes a problem, they becomes a thorn on the woman's flesh. And at times, most women leave the marriage if their husband is not strongly beside them, but when the husband is strongly beside them, you see the man, backing up from the family, okay, which is not good. So what advice I give to my Igbo people, when you love a woman and that woman has all it takes for you to call her my woman, men, you are not going to spend the rest of your life with your parents.
That one is true.
And your sisters, you can only stay with them with like 0 to 30 years, if at all 35.
Yes.
And it's over. So the rest years left for you, you will stay in with the woman. Even when the man is sick, it must be the woman. The woman cooks, give birth to children, you know, cook for you, do a lot of things, you know. Problem we have, as in some Igbo sister-in-laws, when they get married, the brothers, you know, get married to the wife.
Mm-hmm.
And when the wife try to keep, maybe, for example, they always keep their televisions or their gas, maybe this way. As a new wife, you like to, you know, change the position of things.
Yeah,
as
the house, yeah.
Head, owner of the house, mm-hmm. This is your home. If truly you want to settle down, you move it the other way. Some of the sisters did not come to say, don't put it that way. Oh, it has not been like this. This has always been like this. Oh, and it must be like this. And this is a woman that came in as, oh, this is my home. I want to build this home with your brother. It becomes a problem. I have a lot of friends that face such challenges. Oh, but at the end, you know, the husband came back to his senses, which the marriage is working well, and sent all the relatives and so out. As in, pay for house rent for them, look for another flat so that he will maintain and manage his home. I think his home. So not sending your families away from you without settling them. You settle them, okay? So this issue of, especially Igbos, is not only to Cameroon. They do it within us,
within
Igbos, you understand? Okay. So that is it. It's not only for Cameroonians or Ghanaians, no. Within us Igbos, we face the same thing. So, do you have any regrets of coming in contact with a Nigerian or all with super thumbs up?
I am super joy to know this family. Super, super, super. Even in the next way, even if I die, I come back, I will still like to know them again.
Okay.
Yes, I don't have any regret knowing them.
Alright.
They are nice people.
Alright. What do you think, Cameroonians?
My dear Cameroonian sisters and brothers,
mm-hmm.
Please you push your like, share and subscribe this video.
Okay.
Follow Mama
Ever Mom G's TV.
Correct.
So my Cameroonians, do you hear what she said? Pounds and dollars. Dollar mass, okay? From Cameroon, okay? She says, subscribe to my channel. So thank you so much, Dollar Mass. I'm happy to have you here in my channel. So we are one family, okay? Cameroon, Nigeria, a girl, according to Germans, they say what?
It's a
girl, okay? Under the umbrella of one continent, which is Africa. We are one. So thank you so much, Dollar Mass. I'm happy to have you. So speak one.
Love you guys.
So tell Cameroonians with your mother's prophet to subscribe to my channel. Chineke! I'm going to end this video here. So till I come your way next time, this is still your Ever Mom G's TV. Please don't forget to subscribe and share this video. So guys, thank you so much for watching up to this time. I appreciate every one of you. You have heard what Dollar Mass said. So all my Cameroonian friends, so subscribe, like, and share this video. So let me see your thoughts about this video. If you have anything to contribute or you have any question concerning this video, don't hesitate to write under the comment section. I will surely get back to you. So thank you so much. Till I come your way next time, this is still your Ever Mom G's TV. So bye-bye.